The word of God you receive grace with is John chapter 1, verses 1 to 7. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, but the darkness has not understood it. There came a man who was sent from God. His name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so that through him all men might believe. Amen. The Lord has been for all eternity. He created everything and humans, but the man did wrong things, which the Lord commanded him not to do by the devil's schemes. As a result, humans were cursed, get sick, die, and suffer pain forever in hell by the wages of sin. The Lord exists as spirit that we cannot touch or see. He revealed himself as the Word in the beginning. The Word was with God. The Word is apposition to God. The Word is God. If you acknowledge the Word of God as God, please say Amen. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him, nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, but the darkness has not understood it. Who is he who appeared in the darkness? They didn't understand him. He came to the earth and healed the sick, drove out demons, raised the dead, healed leprosy, gave sight to the blind, healed the lame, deaf, and mute, healed the crippled, and raised the dead. However, he shone his light upon them. They didn't understand. Isn't he the son of Joseph who was born in Nazareth? They didn't know him more than that. So John, whom the Lord sent, came to the earth and witnessed Jesus. The Word became flesh, who made his dwelling among us, to make many people believe in him. But they didn't believe in Jesus. So John 1:14 says, "The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth." However, the Lord wants to give you his grace and truth through his Word. If you don't know it, you would say, "It's the pastor's word." Then it has nothing to do with you. For example, Peter and John were going up to the temple at the time of prayer, at 3 in the afternoon. A crippled man from birth asked them for money. Peter looked straight at him, as did John. Then Peter said, "Look at us. Silver or gold I do not have, but what I have I give you." So the man expected to get something from them. He opened up his mind towards them, and Peter said, "In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, walk!" But if he had said to Peter, "Hey, who are you that say to me, who has been crippled from birth, to stand up?" and did not stand up, he would sit there as before. When we accept the word of God, we should be the one who fulfills the word of God Almighty as it is. When Jesus went into a synagogue in Capernaum and began to teach, some men made an opening in the roof above Jesus. Jesus looked up. Then 4 men lowered the mat that the paralyzed man was lying on. Jesus said to the paralytic, "Son, your sins are forgiven." He was feeling uneasy because they made an opening in the roof above Jesus. It was so rude. He might have felt very awkward. And he worried, "Will he really heal me or not? Will I really be healed or not?" He was uneasy. Jesus said to the paralytic, "Son, your sins are forgiven. Get up, take your mat and walk." If the paralytic said to Jesus, "Hello, if I get up, take my mat and walk, why was I carried here? I cannot walk, so I'm here like this," then he should lie down on the mat as before. When we listen to the word of God and believe it will be done as it is, the word will work through us. Who? He experienced the Lord, who was the word, became flesh. The Lord wants to help us, and the word of God is alive, and the Lord who said it is alive. He's not temporarily alive, but he lives forever and loves me and works. But if we don't receive his love, will it be useful? When we know the one who loves me and how much I should receive his love and how much he can love me, then we can receive his love. But the Lord loves me without any limitation. I bless you in the name of the Lord to receive his love without any limitation. The word of God is written in the Bible. And the Lord did his work to redeem us, as the word says. However, we cannot see him, hear him, or touch him. So, there are a lot of people who think that they just go to church religiously. The Lord appeared to us to show us who he is. If we deny it, though the Lord, who is omniscient and omnipotent, wants to help us with his almighty power, he can't, and we can't receive his help. Not knowing who God is such a great loss. It's such a great loss. The Lord absolutely fulfills what he said. As much as we live according to the word of the Lord, it will be fulfilled. If you want to live with the Lord, please say Amen. Yes. It's very important to be together. In the Old Testament, Abraham walked with the Lord. The prophets walked with the Lord. It means that they followed the Lord and walked together beside him. Within means that the Word is in me. The Holy Spirit is in me. Jesus' name is in me. Jesus' blood is in me. And the promise is in me. It means it's in me. So we are not those who are walking beside together with the Lord. But He is in us, together with us. If you understand, please say Amen. But you say, where is God? Because you cannot see Him, hear Him, or touch Him. Though you come to church, when you have some problems you can't overcome, you don't think about the Lord. You are wondering, what should I do? How can I solve it? Where is a doctor in a hospital? The Lord has gone somewhere. Then where is God, whom you have heard through His Word? Where is He? Dear friends, He is not far away from you. He is in you. He is everywhere. He is right there to help you when you find Him. He who obeys His voice should believe that what He promised will be fulfilled as it is. Why does the Lord fail to love us? It's because we belong to Him. We belong to Him. Let's say together, all things belong to the Lord. And I also belong to Him. People have a lot of things for themselves. Sometimes they are keeping and cherishing things which nobody wants. Why does the Lord love us? Why does the Lord give the rain and sun to things and raise them? It's because they belong to God. The Lord raises us, takes care of us, and loves us. Psalm 100, verse 3 says, "Know that the Lord is God. It is He who made us, and we are His. And we are His people, the sheep of His pasture. We are His. I bless you in the name of the Lord to surely become His." Isn't it a blessing when we belong to the Lord? Man committed sin in the Garden of Eden and was handed over to the devil. It is because he who does what is sinful is of the devil. When man committed sin, from that moment he belonged to the devil and became his. 1 John 3:8 tells us about it. So the Lord bought us at a price and made us belong to the Lord and came to us as His temple. He said, "You are mine. You are mine. If you commit sin again, you will become dirty. I will throw you away because you belong to the devil. Do not get out of me." If you acknowledge and accept the wishes of the Lord, who wants to make you happy forever, please say Amen loudly. Everything God made reveals that it has been created by the Lord. Everything which the Lord made is revealed through listening to the voice of the Lord. The Lord made us all from the dust of the ground and breathed life into our nostrils. We are made by the Spirit of the Lord, so we should reveal the Lord in us. How did the Lord make us? The Lord said, "Let us make man in our own image, in our own likeness." We are made in the image of the Lord and His likeness. It is the image of our Lord Jesus Christ, who was before us. Let us find two verses about it. In whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins. He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn over all creation. He is invisible. But when we see us, whose image do we have? It is the Lord Jesus Christ who came to us 2,000 years ago. The Lord Jesus Christ. We should resemble not only His likeness, but also His heart, mind, and power. But why was man who was made in the image of the Lord corrupted? It began from the Garden of Eden, by the devil's work. The devil's work. Committing sin, doing unfortunate things, and going to hell destroyed them to resemble the devil. So they went to hell following the devil. The Lord made us in His image, after His likeness. So we should surely resemble the Lord Jesus Christ. We should look just like the Lord. We resemble the Lord. So we should listen to His voice and live according to it. What did Jesus say when He came to the earth? For I have come down from heaven not to do my will, but to do the will of Him who sent me. And this is the will of Him who sent me, that I shall lose none of all that He has given me, but raise them up at the last day. For my Father's will is that everyone who looks to the Son and believes in Him shall have eternal life, and I will raise him up at the last day. It's in John 6:38 to 40. If we have the same mind and mission as the Lord, wherever we go, people will say to us that we belong to Jesus. We belong to Jesus. Dear friends, as everything is possible for God, and He knows everything, and He is everywhere, there is no need to go and find Him. But God found me and came to me. Who is worried and concerned about the world? They want to control their life themselves. However, once you pass the right of your life to the Holy Spirit, do you not know who you are? Do you not know that you are the temple where God and the Holy Spirit dwell? I paid the wages of your sin with my blood, so you belong to me. I have ownership of you, so I have rights over you. Live according to the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, the touching of the Holy Spirit, and the way He leads you, so that you will not go to hell being dragged by the devil, Satan, and evil spirits, but go to heaven being led by the Holy Spirit. So never possess the rights of your life, but just leave it to me, He said. This is how to obey the Word of God, by the inspiration of the Holy Spirit. Lord, help me to acknowledge God as my master. It's not working like that, for you don't have enough faith to confess it. So God said, I made you from nothing. Isn't it written that I created all creatures in Genesis 1, and I made man with soil and breathed life into his nostrils so that you became alive from nothing? So he calls things that are not as though they were. Romans 4:17 says, I have made you a father of many nations. He is our father in the sight of God, in whom he believed, the God who gives life to the dead and calls into being things that were not. God is our master, my father. He is in my house. He is everywhere I go. If you confess that he is within you, please say amen. So we Christians never struggle with problems for our families or live life as worldly people do. We never struggle because everything belongs to God. God loves and cherishes all the creatures he made and takes responsibility in the end. So we should just obey what he told us through the Bible. Then we will go to heaven. Please say amen. Just do whatever he tells you to do. However the circumstances, conditions, and situations cause you not to obey God, but puts real situations as most urgent. I can't go to the service today. I can't evangelize. I can't obey, though it's the word of God. There are many people leaving God for this reason. I know about this because my parents fought for so long. Not only 1 or 2 years for this reason, not performing ancestral rites and not working on the Lord's Day. It was not even a fight. My father beat my mother, so there was not even one day without blood. People in my town said, should you believe in Jesus like that? Well, you can believe in Jesus, but why should you believe in this extreme way? You are farming, so how can you not work on Sunday? How come? Well, you don't perform the ancestral rites. What kind of religion is it? I think Christians are too far away from our world. There were not many Christians at that time. There were not many Christians, but people were stuck in Confucian ideas and worshipped the ancestor god for farming. Our country was an agricultural nation, not an industrial nation. So we were in that situation, having these kinds of problems. Even other Christians said to her, hey, sister, you should be wiser. What kind of wisdom is it? They meant it for the flesh, having no fight. You should pretend not to go to church if he asks and do the performance of ancestral rites. You should work on Sunday when you have to. Be wiser. Do you really think that is wisdom? If you disobey and leave the word of God, why do you not know that it is sin putting you to death? Why do you not know? So we should all know that it is all about to be or not to be. Faith life is a very extreme thing. Obey or disobey, hell or heaven, the devil's work or God's work. There is only one of the two. Cheating? Cheating is making you sin, and I will pay the wages of it. It's not right. So, no matter what God says to us, we should submit to God, who takes responsibility for us, even though our flesh is going through hardships. There is a hymn my mom always sang when she suffered. The trusting heart to Jesus clings, nor any ill forebodes, but at the cross of Calvary sings, praise God for lifted loads. Singing I go along life's road, praising the Lord, praising the Lord. Singing I go along life's road, for Jesus has lifted my load. The passing days bring many cares. Fear not, I him say. And when my fears are turned to press, the burden slip away. Singing I go along life's road, praising the Lord, praising the Lord. Singing I go along life's road, for Jesus has lifted my load. He tells me of my Father's love, and never slumbering I. My everlasting King above will all my needs supply. Singing I go along life's road, praising the Lord, praising the Lord. Singing I go along life's road, for Jesus has lifted my load. Walking in sunlight all of my journey, over the mountains, through the deep vale, Jesus has said, I will never forsake thee. Promise divine that never can fail. Heavenly sunlight, heavenly sunlight, flooding my soul with glory divine. Hallelujah, I am rejoicing, singing his praises. Jesus is mine. Shadows around me, shadows above me, never conceal my Savior and guide. He is the light, in him is no darkness. Ever I'm walking close shine. Hallelujah, I am rejoicing, singing his praises, Jesus is mine. She sang this hymn. And the last one is always, Nearer, my God, to Thee. She started singing and finished singing with the hymn, The Bright Heavenly Way. But there was no variation to the notes of the tune. But she looked so beautiful. And her face was so bright when she knelt down, raising her right hand and worshipping God. Yes. There was blood all over her body, for she was beaten. It was the worship and confession of the blood. I sang along with her, sitting right next to her. We were unhappy and sad for my father. But once my mum started singing, I sang along with her and cried. It feels like yesterday. Dear friends, you should listen carefully if you want to submit to God. It's not about the flesh. You should leave your heart and soul to Him. However, the devil, demons, and Satan give you all hardships and sufferings to bind you in the situation for your flesh. But you should not let the devil take your soul, though you die. You should not let him take you. The moment once you let him do it. Dear friends, if my mom lost the fight because of the persecution, I would not be here. I would probably not be a Christian now. I would feel so tired of Jesus Christ. I would probably think, this horrible family, since I was young, I've suffered so much because of that Jesus Christ. However, since I was young, my pastor preached, if you believe in Jesus, you will suffer and be persecuted as Jesus was. Blessed is the man who is persecuted for righteousness. Keeping God in you is righteousness. Keeping the word of God is righteousness. Living according to his word is righteousness. However, when you get persecuted in this life, you'll be rewarded. Your reward will be great in heaven. So, my dear friends, we should not be frustrated by our flesh. The devil, Satan, and demons will persecute your flesh as they did Peter and Paul. However, they achieved freedom in their conscience, soul, and evidence of the gospel for the Lord. This freedom. Then you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. Freedom. Please say amen. Freedom. Martha and Mary had serious concerns. So they sent people to find Jesus. Lord, my brother is sick and about to die. Please come and heal him. I will go and heal him. But Jesus was still preaching the gospel. After the fourth day, he finally reached the town of Bethany. When he arrived, unlike Korean funerals that are 4-5 days, people in the Middle East bury the dead on the same day. They don't wait because the temperature in the summer reaches 44 to 46 degrees Celsius, so a dead body quickly rots. Hence they bury them and have the funeral as soon as people die. Likewise, they had buried him at the tomb already. Martha went out to meet Jesus. Jesus, if only you had been here, my brother would not have died. Because you were not here, he died. She believes that Jesus heals the sick, but can't raise the dead. You should not limit believing in Jesus. Never set a parameter. Believe in him limitlessly. Limitlessly. Believing that he is Almighty, who makes all things possible and can do everything. For whom does he know and do everything? It's needless to say that it's for me. For me. For me. Then Jesus said, Martha, you would see God's glory if you believe. Only if you believe. Everyone who lives in me and believes in me will never, ever die. Yes, it will be the last day. She gives an irrelevant answer. An irrelevant answer. The Lord feels heavy. He wants to see her faith, but can't. Martha returned and Jesus said, tell Mary that I am here. So Mary immediately came to Jesus. Mary was so much loved by the Lord. Lord, if only you had been here, my brother would not have died. She said the same. Friends, please listen. He can heal a cold, but not cancer. It's not true. He can heal the young, but not the old. It's not true either. Please do not limit him. Only if you do not limit him today, the Lord works. Then he works. Don't limit him. In case of this serious sin, the Lord would never forgive me. The blood of Jesus on the cross doesn't matter how serious the sin is. Since I committed such a serious sin, I'll be punished by that. Even though you repented, you still blame yourself. Why do you do that? I repented by the blood of Jesus, so I feel happy and shed tears and am filled with the Holy Spirit. I was forgiven, but soon afterwards I blame myself again. Ah, this sin is so serious that I'll never be forgiven so easily. That's the work of the devil. The blood of Jesus never limits any sin. All sins are the same, and there's not a big difference. Only by the blood can it be solved. The only sin that would never be forgiven, even by repentance, is blasphemy against the Holy Spirit. The Lord told us it won't be forgiven even in the coming age. Therefore, it says, I tell you, do not repent for sin which is not able to be forgiven. Why do you limit the work of God? Why do you limit him? You think God can only work up to this point, not over it. Martha and Mary thought that their brother could only be healed if Jesus came while he was sick and still alive. But they thought it's over, as he had died. How far should we go before giving up on our faith? No matter what the circumstances are, no matter what conditions we have, we should never give up. It is the devil that makes you give up. Never lose because of him. Never. How could big things work? No way. How would Jesus solve his big problem? No way. This is the work of the devil. Then there goes another assumption. Why would God love someone like me? Do you think that the blood of Jesus has left out someone like you? The grace of God who gave us all creation left only you out? No. Why do you say that God left me out, even though you live by the grace of God? He gave all creation because of someone like me. All because of me, he sent his son, whom he shed blood and died in order to give us eternal life in heaven. I am the one who should be blessed by the grace. blessed by the grace. Dear friends, those who can't realize their sins aren't qualified to believe in Jesus. Therefore, the Lord said, I have not come to call the righteous. Self-proclaiming that I have no sins, He didn't come to call this person. The Lord has come to call upon the sinners to repent. Those who have impossibilities need Jesus. Do not draw the line. Why do you stack the walls and say this is the thing which God can deal with, and that is the thing God cannot deal with? Why do you delineate the ability of God? The Lord said, hey, where have you laid him, your brother? Let's go there. So the Jews followed him. They all followed him. As they went, as a courtesy of the Jews, they must be going to pay their condolences. They went to the tomb. The Lord said, take away the stone. By this time there's a bad odor, for he's been there for 4 days. Did I not tell you if you believed you'd see the glory of God? Please don't limit the faith. Believe without limitation. Try praying based on such faith. Listen to the word with such faith. Accept it. Don't block it or limit it. Let's see. I shall not limit the spiritual ministry of the Lord towards me. Never put a limitation. Accept it. Martha and Mary, if you believed, you would see the glory of God. Dear friends, now we should be Martha and Mary. Since you are the main character who is listening to the word of God, do you have the Lord's day? The preacher is there speaking to you. Don't forget it. It's not for someone else, but for you. The Jews have said, hey, he can make the blind person to see and the deaf person to hear. But he cannot save Lazarus. They whispered from behind. The stone was taken away. Then Jesus looked up and said, Father, I thank you that you have heard me. I knew that you always hear me, but I said this for the benefit of the people standing here, that they may believe that you sent me. I am not the son of Nazareth. I am not the same human as you are. I am the Son of God who was sent by Him. If you can believe that I am the Creator, then you will see the glory. Lazarus, come out! As he was called, the dead man walked out wrapped in cloth. Everyone was going insane. Even the Jews, Pharisees, Mary and Martha. What's going on? What is happening? Dear friends, as I was growing up, I've never seen anything which is impossible by prayer. If not, then the limitation of your faith is only that much. Faith is accepting God, believing and entrusting that things will happen as God said. So listen well. Even when you pray, you may ask me for anything in my name, and I will do it. What does this mean? Do you have any impossible thing? I will promise you with all my honor. Do it in my name. Pray for all your problems through the prayer is to me. As you entrust the construction company with the building of your house, entrust them to me. I will take care of it. Entrusting God like this is faith. This is the spiritual relationship between the Lord and you. For that purpose, the Lord is there. And that is why you are here. What is repentance? The sin that makes me ill, cursed, and takes me to hell. I will entrust all these to the Lord, and I will leave the sin. So the sin has nothing to do with me. The Lord has carried such sins and died on the cross. The wages of sin has gone. I am free. When you entrust the Lord like this, then you are free. So if you know faith, the faith will set you free. What is our faith? Why did the Word appear? It is because sin is discovered through the Word, and the Word tells me how my unfortunate things can be resolved. And we get to know how the devil and Satan are trying to harm us and take us to hell. Each word of God is the pinnacle of love towards me. It's the pinnacle of grace, the pinnacle of freedom away from suffering. Then why is it that we are so difficult to hear His Word? Why is it so hard to keep and live by His Word? The devil troubles your mind and gives pain to your body. It keeps you from laying yourself down to Him, to His Word, and to Jesus. The devil's work takes you out from God's hands, making you say, "It's too hard, I cannot do it." What does the Bible say? You shall obey the word of God. Resist the devil that keeps you from obeying God. Then it will be gone. Why don't you think that it's the devil's work? You are bound by ropes of physical environment, realities, and circumstances. You fell into the hole and regretted your fate and destiny, saying, "I don't know why I'm like this." No, that's the working of the devil, Satan, and sin. Only Christ, the Lord Jesus Christ, can deliver you from this. What's repentance? Sin is disobeying the word of God. Dear friends, no matter what you do, any disobedience to God's word is sin. To return to Him, you should repent of your sin of disobedience that separated you from God. God wants you to repent completely and receive happiness from God. God paid the wages of sin and bought you with His blood so that you can enjoy eternal life in heaven. Trusting and believing in God begins with repentance. Disobeying God's word is sin. Not following His word is sin. Who made you disobey God? It's the working of the devil, Satan, and demons. One day, medicine will overcome cancer. When I was a kid, anyone who got tuberculosis had no way to live and died. No one overcame it, and they all died. As tuberculosis was contagious, nobody entered the patient's house. Once it grew serious, people bound a rope around the house to keep others from entering in. It was a warning for others not to enter the house. The disease was so dreadful for us. These days, it's easily cured by medication. It's nothing. However, Anyone who gets cancer dies. For cancer, having surgery is the only way to overcome it. One day, we will overcome cancer. It will be easily cured by medication, like colds. The day will come that cancer is overcome. But nothing in the world can overcome sin since the days of Adam. You can overcome it only by the blood from the Son of God's death. Then He will deal with every problem that you have. Everything is resolved when sin is resolved. Do you understand this? In the beginning was the Word. When the Word was revealed, sins are revealed, not following the Word. The Word was with God, and the Word was God. God is righteous. God is the standard of righteousness. He became flesh and made His dwelling among us. We saw God, the Word, with our own eyes. All His works are healing human sicknesses, resolving curses, destroying the devil, Satan, and demons, and being killed to save me from sin. He did nothing but love me. He is my God. When you accept this, you will have faith and the desire to throw yourself to Jesus, confessing, "Lord, please accept me and use me by your will." If you can't give yourself to Jesus, you should acknowledge God's word, for it came from not trusting or acknowledging Him. You should accept God's word. Don't you accept this? Even though you saw Jesus' life and the Holy Spirit came on you, dwelt in you, and made you holy as evidence of redemption from sin, that's the devil's work that deceives you. You should overcome this. Overcome this. Overcome this. Let's lift up our hands. Lord, let's overcome it. Help me to overcome this. I should win against this. I really have to overcome this. Please forgive my sin of disobeying God. All my sin came from the devil's work that kept me not to trust God and not to lay myself down to Jesus. I did not pray, evangelize, work for God, love other members, or care for other souls. My life did not follow your word and your will. I did not give thanks for the grace of your blood, nor give myself to the grace. You should repent. Not only doing wrong from an ethical point of view is sin, but you should really accept that not trusting God in your relationship with Him is sin. Lord, please forgive me. Today, please give me faith to lay myself down to you by the Holy Spirit. Let's cry out, Lord, three times and pray, Lord! Lord! Lord!